Have you ever wanted to understand the way your credit card works, how black holes are distributed throughout the universe, or which properties you should buy in order to have the highest chance at winning in a game of Monopoly? Each of these questions can be answered by using math, but what is math and how many people actually understand it? When the average person thinks of mathematics, they probably think of computations, like 2 plus 3 equals 5, or the arithmetic of addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. However, math and computation are different. For one, computation is a well-defined model of steps that generate a solution. Just as 2 plus 3 is a computation because the plus sign tells us what to do with the 2 and the 3 to get the solution 5, the sorting of the numbers 1, 4, 100, 52, 3, and 6 from largest to smallest is a computation. The well-defined model of steps is a bit more open to interpretation in this case, as there are many algorithms or recipes to complete this task, but it is still a computation nonetheless. Math, on the other hand, is defined by the Merriam-Webster dictionary as the science of numbers and their operations, interrelations, combinations, generalizations, and abstractions, and of space configurations and their structure, measurement, transformations, and generalizations. In brief, math is a lot more than just 2 plus 3 or ordering a list of numbers. That is, it's a lot more than just computation. In a much broader sense, doing mathematics is making a concrete and deliberate establishment of something that is true based on a set of apparently obvious truths that we call postulates or axioms. These concrete and deliberate establishments are called proofs. It's good to notice that proof and computation are two different things. Computations are done constructively, that is, they are done in steps that give a solution. Proofs, on the other hand, can be constructive and tell you exactly how one statement is deduced from another, or they can be formulated indirectly, which shows the truth of a statement without describing exactly how one statement is deduced from another. The relationship between mathematics and computation is a tangled one, however. Often, mathematicians look to computation to build intuition when studying something new, or as motivation for forming a conjecture or an unproven, seemingly likely possibility. Oftentimes, computers look to math for proofs that tell them about a particularly complicated computation, but often disregard the generality of the statement. But how many people understand math? That is, how many people have some level of mathematical literacy? Taking into account the difference between mathematics and computation, mathematical literacy can be defined as the ability to understand the logic of proofs. As computation is commonly seen as mathematics, to answer this question, we need to figure out when proofs are given preference over computation. Many American universities only grant credit for calculus and statistics for IB and AP programs, but both of these courses tend to veer away from proofs, favoring computations. Although some high schools in the US develop geometry in an axiomatic way, understanding of these proofs does not translate to literacy of mathematics in general. Therefore, we need to focus on college students. The population of the world is estimated to be around 7.5 billion people, and 7% are estimated to have a college degree. That's around 525 million people. According to the distribution of undergraduate degrees from 1970 to 2011, starting in 1970, only around 3% of college graduates received degrees in mathematics, and this number has slowly decreased to around 1% over the last 40 years. However, we're going to overestimate and suppose that 3% of graduates have a degree in mathematics or statistics. That means that only around 0.21% of the world's population have some recognized understanding of mathematical proof. So if you consider mathematical proof and computation as math collectively, then if you learn any math beyond calculus and understand it, you're basically in the top 1% in the world for understanding math. The disparity in knowledge here is pretty great, and under our assumptions, access to mathematical knowledge seems incredibly limited. It really highlights the fact that many applications of mathematical thought, like cryptography and engineering, are truly taken for granted. Anyhow, that's all I have for you in this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and if you did, you can subscribe for more videos each week, except for maybe next week. There are a lot of things going on, and I don't know if I'll be able to get a video up. But aside from that, if you want to take the poll and let me know what I should cover next time, that would be awesome. Anyhow, I am Nathan, this is Chalk, and I will see you next time.